Yeah, what are we going to do, climb mountains or
something? No. I have a hiker. You know what that is? Does it look familiar to you?
What is this? Something stuck on it? Is it a growth or something?
This is supposed to be on the back end, back of his head.
Oh, I see.
And it contradicts all the testimony of all the doctors.
Okay, let me do it. Who are you?
I'm Terry Livingstone.
Okay.
I'm a doctor.
Okay. I never saw the study.
Yeah.
I saw him. He was on the table. Okay, like if you were lying down, he's just standing up. And I came from down here with the equipment, and his head was back up forward, his eyes were open, and he's obviously a dead man. And I went around this way and handed my chief of he was there, some equipment, and helped me to get connected and started. But I saw the man's face like so. And I never, the exit wound was on the other side. And what was back there, I don't know. I never, from personal experience, I did not see that. I did not see this part of his head. See, that would have been here, and I saw him from this direction. But I did not see him from that side.
No, this was the wound that all the doctors saw.
Yeah, that's the way they described it. Then.
Do you know anybody who would help me, who would look at this and say that it was this way or this way?
I don't know where all the people are anymore.
You know what Dr. Perry would do?
Who?
Perry?
I think the chief at that time went up to Washington or Oregon or wherever he went.
Camp?
Fort Camp? He was the chief of
Camp Clark.
Okay.
I know where everyone was except for Perry and for, yeah.
I don't know where any of those people. Perry, I think, is still in academic medicine.
Carrico?
Where is Carrico? I think he's in academic medicine. Maybe with, one of the medical schools as an associate professor or even a professor by now. I don't know, Carrico. We were talking about him just recently. Someone told me where he went, but I have that kind of a mind. It's kind of like a sieve on things like that. And I don't remember where they said he was going to.
Okay, just once more. This wound on page 140 of 6 seconds in Dallas is the way it was described to you by the
Yeah, I visualized it as being a little higher than that, but that's just, it could very well have been that low. I certainly, looking at him from this angle, did not see anything, but that's the way a wound would go. It would, it blows out, the entry is not much, but the exit is what.
So the exit wound would be in the occipital parietal.
Yeah, It would be somewhere on the right posterior part of it.
Right. And then this photograph in the appendices. Would you like me to send you a copy of this book? It's the medical evidence. This on page 104 of the appendices.
Drawing depicting the posterior head wound, note also to the hot position, white mass. Is that supposed to be it?
Well, this is here's the white mass. But Dr. Humes, the autopsist, describes that as the entry wound.
But I don't know how you could when he bent forward. I gotta go.
Okay, well, thank you.
Yeah.
Would you say that photograph might be a fake then?
No, I wouldn't say it. Because I don't know.
Yeah.
As far as I know, my doctor and do lots of crazy things.
Yeah.
So, who's the judge? It's kind of hard to tell. Even experts can't tell doctor's photograph. Good luck.
Hi, Dr. Dennis.
Yeah.
My name is Terry. 2 minutes. 2 minutes? I just have a minute and a half. I can spare it.
Okay. This picture on page 104 of volume 7 of the appendix. Does that look familiar to you?
No, not like that.
Not like this. Because we're measuring.
Is it that was an exit wound here in the back of the occipital area?
No, it had an exit wound, entrance wound in the back. No, you want to know what it really looked like?
Yeah.
Is that what you're trying to find? What are you doing this for? What's it for?
Well, I was one of the researchers. I am one of the researchers in the investigation. And we know...
You have your credentials for it?
Well, I can give you an article that was printed in the...
The FBI?
No. but this picture is known to be a forgery. And that was publicized around the world on July 9th. I gave you a copy of the article today.
Well, I don't
But all the doctors at Parkland and Dr. McClellan described this room.
Well, Dr. McClellan was not right there. And people do things according to what they hear and are not hearing about. You ought to look at your number one source. Did you read the article by Latimer, Dr. Latimer? Dr. Latimer is one who's inspected all the autopsy reports and all the photographs and has written it up. And he did this in 1962, and he's the one you should look into. 72. Latimer, Because to the right side is where the bit of piece of scalp was blown on, and the side of your hand.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. What Latimer
right here,
said.
Yeah. Right temporal region.
I can't, by looking at that picture, tell much about it. Same reason the others in the room couldn't tell either. He had such a massive tear that it didn't really show with him on a stretcher. He had this big wound in his head.
Was the head lifted up, or did anybody turn him over so that you could see behind his back? Or
no.
Did anybody lift up the back of the head to see this?
No, I was standing against his head.
Yeah.
And he decided to ruin his head, and he had a bullet hole in the back of his neck. And he was things. And you, this is an exit wound, and this is entrance and exit here.
Mm-hmm.
Which is quite obvious.
Where was the entrance from? Mm-hmm. Where was the entrance from?
On the back, a little bit of the autopsy about here, I suspect. Hi, John.
Oh, the autopsy report put it 2.5 centimeters from the occipital of the protuberance.
Well, that's where I was reaching. You know where your occipital protuberance is?
Yeah.
That's where I was reaching.
No, they moved it in 1968, 4 inches up to here.
Well, I don't know anything about that. I don't know what you're doing.
Thank you.
But look up the article of a man who really did the work on it.
Yeah.
He was given permission by the archivist to review all the autopsy findings, all the photographs, and was written up completely.
Mm-hmm.
And if you hadn't done that, you've missed a whole lot in what you're looking for.
Mm-hmm. But did you place the entry on 6.5 centimeters?
No, no, I'm not going to give you exact.
Okay, well, close to it. Very close to
it. I think that's about the right spot.
Yeah.
I didn't measure it.
Yeah.
Yes, to go. You know what Latimer that is? You know, if you're researching, you've missed
I've heard
what are you researching it for? I'm interested in
that. Well, I'm an author, and we've been
you've got another
for years and years.
Everybody's got another thing.
Yeah,
no, I'm not writing this for... no,
just like the assassination committee. $5 million, 3 years, and last week come up with another theory.
They'll never stop.
They'll never stop?
Yeah. I don't think you know how to go to the book.
Thank you.
You'll get more information here than you get anywhere else, because he had access to the autopsy material. The Warren Commission didn't have.
Right.
The Warren Commission had no opportunity to look at any part of it. This, you know
that. Would you say that that's an entry one?
Well, I don't know. I think so. And that's the wound, as you can tell with your fingers, this part was scored off, and the edge of the wound was blasted out, as you would guess.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
what would you put there? I your statement was that it was a tickle in the ground.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
doctor was a great last person on the right side of the head, something like that. But all these doctors...
I was all unfair about when I took the last bit of the brain. I was there to read them as the autopsy showed, but I didn't examine that part of it. Well, this is all out. This point, the bone was out. I'd only be quoted on something. It's this length of time, if you say that's an accurate, that's the way people write things. They get very inaccurate representation.
But
read this other, so you can get a good...
From right here?
No, there are several. I don't know how many
this
pieces of bone there were.
Photograph,
so well, you know.
And this part is blown away, but you see they have a lot of replacements in here. They've got the bounce process and the mandible and everything that's missing from the picture. The orbit. In the temporal region, it doesn't go on right here. But in the rear, they have those objects that bring it in also, and then put it in the ball, don't they?
Well, that picture doesn't look like a thing. It's my back, because this is my back. It is right. It's already gone. And what is that to represent? Is that the piece of bone that represents?
Yeah, it's flat.
Yeah.
See, the evidence for it could be a good portion of that.
What?
Well, Dr. McClellan said it was good in the left temple. He's trying to find the...
Let's get that straight. Dr. McClellan walked in, I was standing there, and I was beside, I had a finger on the temporal artery to see how good it was on the soft place in the heart. I didn't need to have it there because blood was down my head, down my fuse. All this time, Dr. McClellan said, where was the wound? And I said in his head, and he felt my finger indicated where the hole was. That's the whole background to that. That's what the guy in New Orleans built his case on, which is absolutely wrong. So Dr. McClellan didn't try to exaggerate. He thought I was pointing, and I was hitting the temple artery.
Thank you.
Good. You know, everybody's coming up with so much stuff on this. The Warren Commission, I think, is right, even if they can't reproduce things, and they did a magnificent job not to even have access to the autopsy findings.
Yeah.
That's something. There's been autopsied here, like the law requires,
there's
been no mistake about it.
Right.
They would know on here if this wound is next with the exit wound through which you put a tracheostomy.
Yeah.
But they didn't even know that.
Did you see the wound in the back of the
machine? No, I saw that.
How far down in the back of it?
I'm not going to tell you anymore. I'm giving you the source to go to, will you?
Okay.
I'm giving you exactly, because I'll tell you something in my memory now. How many years has it been? 16?
15.
If I measure, I can tell you how far from the mass blood process and all. I couldn't do it. So then you'd find me at variance of the fact.
Yeah.
So then why am I telling you that? Because you've got a place to get the facts, because they have written it up.
Okay.
More than a Warren Commission who didn't have any picture. Mr. McCarthy, I've had enough. Thank you.
But this one would be much too high, wouldn't it?
Well, I can't see a wound there at all. I think that's a good one. So that's not a good picture.
Thank you, Doctor.
If you come by and want to prove another theory about it, you're just another one of them, and I'm one of them.
So
when you've got sources to go to. If I like to tell you about it, it's just because it's been...
No,
I've
read it.
I've
read it. I've
read it.
Well, go to the man who's done with you. All you have to do is
that. That's the one I just gave you reference for. It has saved you a lot of work.
Mm-hmm.
It really was.
Mm-hmm.
So, good.
Tucker, do you
know? My name is Terry Livingstone. I just want to ask you. Photograph on page 104. Is that the Warren Commission report? It's the Assassination Committee report. Appendices. The Warren Commission never printed any photograph.
No.
This is a tracing of the photograph which I've seen, which is in conflict with all the testimony of the doctors from Parkland Hospital, which described this wound here on page 140. What is that? This is 6 seconds of Dallas. This is Dr. McClellan's testimony. Here's the statement of all the doctors describing occipital, the larger bulk of injury is the right occipital parietal region.
Right.
Dr. Jones, what appeared to be an exit wound in the posterior portion of the skull. Dr. Baxter, a large gaping wound in the back of the skull. Massive opening on the back of the head.
Yeah.
Is that what you remember?
Yeah.
So would you say that this picture on page 140 is the most accurate representation?
Well, it's been a long time.
Yeah.
From what I saw, I think that's a reasonable representation.
On page 140. Was the head lifted up from the table or somebody look at it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you do that?
In fact, shine the light in the cranial vault there. And you noticed a large amount of, it's empty.
Yeah. Where was the light shine from? Outside?
Yeah.
Yeah. And who held the head up? Do you remember?
All right.
Yeah. Where was the entry wound? Do you remember?
Right here.
Well, Dr. Hume, the autopsist, described this as an entry wound, just as a hairline near the midline of the head. This spot, would that correspond? Well, there was an entry wound in the back of the neck.
Yeah.
Could that have gone up into the head?
No, but I think bone fragments could have.
Yeah. But he was, they said that wound came out of his throat, the back of the neck.
Oh, yeah, but it's possible that pieces could have gone in several directions, bone fragments, especially here from this one to this one.
Oh, but this, you think that this was the head wound here on the hairline to the back of the neck? I mean, the hairline, this little module?
Yeah, you see, it's possible that one broke the skull, and then fragments of broken skull could have gone every which way.
Yeah. But was this blown out in the picture?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
It was missing. It was
this mark here up at the top of the ruler wouldn't correspond to any empty one that he saw, would it? At the collar? Is this the collar?
Well, it could be.
Yeah. See, the autopsy report described an entry wound 2.5 centimeters from the occipital.
Right.
And then in 1968, the Clark panel moved that wound 4 inches up to near the top of the head. He figured it out.
Well, figure what out?
How did the wound move? But this
well, the wound didn't move. Maybe people's recollection of it moved.
Right, that's what Dr. Hunt told me. Right? She said she could do a lot of funny things in the dark room, too. So, this mark right here near the hairline, on the hairline, at the midline of the head, that would correspond to your recollection of the entry wound for the head wound.
Well, okay, I guess I better explain to you that my total amount of... Well, first I should ask you, what do you care?
Oh, I'm one of the researchers in this thing. We believe...
Researchers in what thing? Who do you represent?
Well, I represent myself. I mean, you know, there are quite a few people that are trying to get to the bottom of these murders because too many of our friends are getting killed. And so we're looking into it. We brought about this investigation for the committee, and I have seen these photographs, and I believe...
This is the recent one. This is the one that just went over...
Nobody has
this
book. No one has this book yet. You might want to get it. This is volume 7 of the medical evidence of the appendix. Now, we believe that he was struck twice in the head, once from behind and once from in front. And there was
I disagree with that.
Exit wound here.
I disagree with that. I go along with, I tell you who I think has the right idea, is a urologist by the name of...
Latimer.
Mm-hmm. Latimer. I read his work, and I think they make a lot of sense.
Mm-hmm.
I think they make a lot of sense.
But... You do remember the exit wound being like that?
Yeah, I remember something like that.
Okay, that's page 140 of the...
But it's been a long time now.
Yeah.
I tried to write down at the time, and my recollections are in the Warren Committee report. I sat down afterwards and wrote a pretty thorough narrative, which I submitted in the form of a letter. And most of I came in the room and my contact with the president was very brief because the governor was across the hall, and so I had to retire and go across the hall to take care of him. Mm-hmm. And he, of course, was shot through the chest. Mm-hmm. You're familiar with that. So the rest of the day, then, I spent with the governor. And Dr. Jenkins stayed in with the president for the remainder of the time until they declared him dead.
But you were present when they shined the light into the camera?
Well, yes, I in order to really tell you in a reliable and reproducible and predictable way, I would have to consult the narrative that I wrote at that time.
Could I see a copy of that sometime?
Oh, sure. Well, let's see. Florence, do you have a copy of that 3 pages of Parkland?
Oh, I have the one from the Texas Medical Journal.
Yeah, that's it.
This right here?
Yeah, that's it. You're well prepared.
All right. If you've read this, you know more about what I recall about the thing than I remember.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. This is it. I was here when they did this examination. There was a large wound beginning right occiput, extending to the parietal region, much of the posterior skull appeared gone. Previously described, extruding brain was present, profuse bleeding had occurred, and 1,500 cc's blood was on the drapes. Both cerebellar and cerebral tissue were extruding from the wound. We determined that by shining a light back there. By this time, this is what I actually did. I actually hooked up the electrocardiograph to the president. That was really my the sum of my activities.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, see here, Dr. Aiken, a resident, and Dr. Giesecke connected the cardioscope.
Dr. McClellan indicated today that this is accurate.
Yeah, I think that's a reasonable picture. I hadn't seen that picture before.
I'll leave this with you.
Have you talked to Dr. Clark?
No, I haven't.
This basically is his area of expertise, and he's the one that really did the examination and shined the light in there.
He's a neurosurgeon.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I really didn't. That's just a description of the devil.
Yeah.
So it's...
Okay. I appreciate that.
Well, I'm sorry I haven't helped you a whole lot, I don't think.
Yeah. Well, we'll
but in my... I think it's a darn shame that we weren't able to do the autopsy here. I believe that if we had done the autopsy here, you know, Dr. Rose was our forensic pathologist and did autopsies on approximately 300 murdered people every year. Now, that's a lot of murdered people, and he knows how to find an entry wound and an exit wound, and he knows, I think if he had done the autopsy, a lot of things where we have questions now would be answered. But instead the body was taken away and the autopsy was done elsewhere. We can't change that.
This looks kind of fictitious.
Yeah. That's not the way I remember it.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Well, good luck to you.